of mathematics class 10. Dear students, in the previous video we learned the trigonometric ratios, okay, and we solved the examples when the value of one of the trigonometric ratios is given, then how to find out the values of remaining trigonometric ratios, right? In this video we are going to use the trigonometric to solve the word problems. Okay, so let's see. Dear students, many times we need to know the height of a tower, building, tree, or the distance of a ship from the lighthouse. We cannot measure them, but we can find out the height or distance between them by using the trigonometry. Okay, so before going to solve such examples, we should know some basic terms related to the trigonometry. Okay, so let's see that. To calculate the height of buildings, tower, or a distance of a ship from a lighthouse, we draw a rough sketch to show the given information. Trees, hills, or towers are vertical objects, so we shall represent them in the figure by segments which are perpendicular to the ground. We will not consider height of the observer, and we shall normally regard observer's line of vision to be parallel to the horizontal line. So let's see, what is this line of vision or horizontal line? Okay, so dear students, let's consider this. Here, if the observer is standing at point A, okay, and looking at the point B, okay, observer is at the point A and looking at the object which is the at the height more than the observer. Okay, now here from the eyes of the observer, which is the straight line, that is called the horizontal line. Okay, and observer is looking at upside, so this line joining the points A and B, that is called line of vision. Okay, and the angle forms between this horizontal line and line of vision is called angle of elevation, right? In short, we can say that when the person is looking at upside, then there is an angle of elevation. Okay? Now, let's consider this. In this figure, the observer is at height and looking at the object which is at downside. Okay, suppose person is standing at the top of the building and looking at the car which is on the road. Okay, in such a case, now the straight line from the observer's eyes is the horizontal line. Okay, now person is looking at the object which is downside. So this segment AB or this ray AB we can call it as the line of vision. Okay, now the angle between this horizontal line and line of vision is called the angle of depression. It means that when the person is looking downside, then there is a formation of angle of depression. Okay, so dear students, this is the angle of elevation when the person is looking outside, and this is the angle of depression when the person is looking downside. Okay, always keep it in our mind, these angles are formed with the horizontal line. Okay, horizontal line and line of vision. Okay, now you can see here observer eyes. So from the observer eyes, what is this straight line? That is the horizontal line. Okay, when the person is looking downside, this is the line of vision, so there is an angle of depression. Okay, now observer is looking upside, then this is the horizontal line and this is the line of vision, so this is the angle of elevation. Okay, so here we can say that when we look up, it is an angle of elevation, and when you look down, it is an angle of depression. Okay, I hope it's clear to you when the angle of elevation and when the angle of depressions are formed.
You're familiar with trigonometric ratios. Now let's look at some commonly used trigonometric terms. We look at these terms from the point of view of Jimmy, the cat, whom we'll consider as the observer. Jimmy is hungry. That's when he spots Timmy, the rat. The line drawn from the eye of the observer, Jimmy to the object, Timmy, is called the line of sight. Timmy wants to escape from Jimmy, so he climbs up the lamppost. Now, Jimmy's line of sight is parallel to the ground level. This is called the horizontal level. Slowly, Jimmy advances towards Timmy. Sensing danger, Timmy climbs higher up the lamppost until he reaches the top. Now, Jimmy looks up towards Timmy. The angle made by the line of sight with the horizontal level, when the object viewed is above the horizontal level, is called the angle of elevation. Jimmy is very angry, but he won't give up. He runs towards the lamppost and starts climbing up. Just as Jimmy reaches the top, Timmy jumps down to the ground. So Jimmy is looking down angrily at Timmy. The angle formed by the line of sight with the horizontal level when the object viewed is below the horizontal level is known as the angle of depression. Jimmy sure is depressed. He has only one option left. He decides to jump down to catch his prey. But alas, he lands on the roof of a passing car. Poor Jimmy. It's just not his day today.
Let's apply the trigonometry to solve the word problems. Okay? So here we have a question. A boy standing at a distance of 48 meters from a building observes the top of the building and makes an angle of elevation of 30 degrees. Find the height of the building. Okay? So as I told you that in the question, in such a question, tower, building, tree, lighthouse, these things we have to consider as perpendicular to the ground. Okay? And we have to represent it in the form of diagram. Okay? So here you can see here I have drawn the triangle ABC in which this AB represents the building. Okay? And point C is the position of a ball. Okay? So here is the ball. AB is the building. Now boy is looking at the top of the building. Okay? So when the person is looking upside, then there is the angle of elevation. That's why this is the angle ACB is of 30 degrees. Okay? And the boy is standing. The boy is standing at a distance of 48 meters from the building. Okay? So AB is the building, C is the position of a boy. That's why distance BC will get 48 meters. Okay? So here, after drawing the figure, we have to explain the figure in a short. So in this way, we can explain the figure. Okay? Let AB represent the building. Point C is the position of the boy. Then write down what things are given. So here, angle ACB 30 degree and BC is 48 meter. Both these are given to us. Okay? Now, let's find out the what we have to find out the height of the building. It means here we have to find out the length of AB. Okay. Now here theta is given, adjacent side is given, and we have to find out the opposite side. Okay. Now here, which is that trigonometric ratio where we are using the opposite side and adjacent side. Okay. So these trigonometric ratios are tan theta and cot theta. Okay. In the both we are using for tan theta, we are using the opposite upon adjacent. While in the case of cot theta, we are using the adjacent upon opposite. Okay. So in one of this we can use to solve this example. Okay. Now generally we are using the tan value. Okay. So here tan 30 is equal to opposite AB upon adjacent BC. Okay, and the value of tan 30 is 1 upon root 3. Okay, is equal to AB, we don't know, BC is given 40. Okay, now here we want to find out the AB. So let's take, transfer this 48 to this side. It is dividing, it will multiply. So we will get AB is equal to 48 upon root 3. Okay, so here whenever we get such a question, in that case this denominator is a third, then we have to rationalize the denominator. Okay, so AB is equal to 48 upon root 3. To rationalize this, we have to multiply this fraction by root 3, numerator as well as denominator. Okay, so root 3 upon root 3. So here we get 48 root 3, and root 3 into root 3 will get 3. Okay, so here we can simplify this. 3 1 3, this is the 18. So in this way we get the AB is equal to 16 root 3 meter. Okay, now in a sub question, if we are given with the value of root 3, so value of root 3 is 1.72. Okay, so if the value of root 3 is given, then at last we can put that value. If it is not given in the question, then we can write our answer in the with the root sign only. Okay, so here we not asked to find out the AB. For our convenience, we might consider the AB this figure. Okay, what was our question? Find the height of the building. So we have to write our last answer in the board. Therefore, the height of the building is 16 root 3 meter. Okay, I hope it's clear to you.
Let's see next example. From the top of the lighthouse, an observer looks at a ship and finds the angle of depression to be 30 degrees. If the height of the lighthouse is 100 meters, then find how far the ship is from the lighthouse.
So dear students, in this question, an observer is standing at the top of the lighthouse, okay, and looking at the ship downside. So there will be the angle of depression, okay. When the person is looking downside, then there is the angle of depression, okay. And here we represent this lighthouse and ship in the form of figure, okay. So here we can say this segment AB represents the lighthouse, okay. Then see the position of the ship. Okay, now here the height of the lighthouse is already given, that is 100 meters. So here AB is equal to 100 meter. Okay, now angle of depression is given. Angle of depression. So here, dear students, many times the students are taking the angle here. Okay, it means here. If you will take the angle of depression here, then it will be wrong. Okay, because we are knowing that angle of depression or angle of elevation are always formed with the horizontal line. Okay, now observer is here at the point A. Okay, so from the straight line, okay, from the observer's eyes, which is the straight line, that is the horizontal line. Okay, and the observer is looking at the ship which is downside. Okay, so angle of elevation and angle of depression, both these are forming with the horizontal line and line of vision. Okay, so this is the line of vision and this is the horizontal line. Okay, so angle will form here. Okay, so here we can say horizontal line. Okay, so angle always form with the horizontal line and line of vision. Okay, so here angle BAC is equal to 30 degree, AB 100 meter, which is 3. Okay, now here in this question we have to find out the adjacent side, but we don't know this angle. But here we are knowing that this horizontal line and this ground level both are parallel each other, and AC is their transversal. That's why we can say that angle BAC is equal to angle ACB. Okay, angle ACB is equal to angle DAC, alternate angles. Okay, so angle ACB is equal to DACB, that is 30 degree. That's why we get the angle ACB is also 30 degree. Okay, now we are knowing in this triangle, that angle triangle ABC, we are going to theta. We are knowing its opposite side. We want to find out its adjacent side. Okay, so here also we can use the either the tan 30 or cot 30. So as already I told you in the previous question that the radial is in the tan 30 only. By both way, the answer will be same. Only we have to take care. If you will write the cot 30, then you have to write the value of cot 30. Okay. So here we wrote the tan 30 is equal to opposite side AB upon adjacent side BC. Okay. Value of tan 30 is 1 upon root 3 is equal to AB is 100 meter upon BC. That we have to find. Okay. So let's take the cross multiplication. So here BC is equal to 100 into root 3. Okay. So dear student, here also we are not given the value of root 3 in the question. That's why we can write our answer in the form of root 3 only. Okay. So here we'll write the question was there. What is the distance of a ship from the lighthouse? So we have to write the answer. Distance of a ship from the lighthouse is 100 root 3 meter. Okay. I hope it's clear to you.
Let's take another example. Two buildings are facing each other on a road of width 12 meter. From the top of the first building, which is 10 meter high, the angle of elevation of the top of the second is found to be 60 degree. What is the height of the second building?
So dear students, in this question, we have the two buildings. So let's represent the two buildings in the form of figure. So here, in the figure, let segment AB and segment CD. This segment AB and segment CD represent the two buildings. Okay? Then, segment BC represent the road. Okay? The buildings are on the either side of the road. Okay? So, this is the road and its length is given 12 meter. Okay? Then, the segment ED is the horizontal. Because here, the observer is at the top of the building whose height is 10 meter. Okay? It means the observer is at the point D looking at the top of the another building. Okay? So that time angle of elevation is there 60 degree. So as the observer is here, that's why this ED is the horizontal. Okay? So we have to find out the height of this second building. Okay? It means we have to find out the AB. Okay, so let's solve this. So here, this DC is 10 meter, BC 12 meter, which is given, and this angle ADE is equal to 60 degree. Okay, now this quadrilateral BCDE is a rectangle. Why it is a rectangle? So as we are knowing that buildings, tower, tree, lighthouse, these things we have to consider as the perpendicular to the ground. So these both are perpendicular to the ground. It means that angle B and angle C is of 90 degrees. So quadrilateral whose adjacent angles are of 90 degrees is the rectangle. Okay? So that's why this quadrilateral B, C, D, E is the rectangle. Okay? Then why we are showing it is a rectangle? So that we can use its property that opposite sides are equal. Right? So here as it is a rectangle, so we can say that EB, segment EB is equal to CD. So here CD we are having 10 meter. Okay? Similarly, this BC is equal to ED. So BC is 12, that's why ED is also 12 meter. Okay? So that only we have written here, B is equal to BC, which is of 10 meter. Then BC is equal to ED, that is 12 meter, opposite sides of rectangle are equal. Okay? Now, in a triangle AED, in this triangle AED, here theta is 60 degree, its adjacent side is given. Now we have to find out the opposite side. Actually, we want to find out the whole length AB. Okay? So now we got this EB. We need only AE. Okay? So, in the triangle AED, adjacent side is there, theta is there. So, let's find out this opposite side by taking the tan 60. So, tan 60 is equal to opposite side, that is AE upon adjacent side ED. Okay? So, let's put the value. We are writing the value of tan 60 as root 3. Okay? AE, we don't know. ED, that is 12. Okay, so this 12 is divided in way, multiply, so in this way we'll get the AE is equal to 12 root 3. AE, we got this as the 12 root 3. What we have to find out? The height of this second building, that is A. Okay, now we have to run here, this AB is nothing but AE plus EB, right? AB is equal to AE plus EB because these are collinear. Okay, therefore AB is equal to AE, we got 12 root 3 plus this EB. EB is already we are knowing, that is 10. Okay, so as here these are not the lights, so we cannot solve this afterwards. So here the height of the second building is 12 root 3 plus 10 meter. Okay, so I hope it's clear to you. So dear students, here in this video we solved the some word problems which we are facing in our real life. By using the trigonometry, we can find out the height or distance between the ship and the lighthouse or the buildings, like that we can solve. Again, we have seen what is meant by the